I think there's a way in which when we approach the work of justice, which is the work of Black Lives Matter, which is the work of Me Too, which is the work of so many movements that have grown and proliferated over these last several years, what we have to see when we're looking out at crowds and people and leaders is what is the call for justice that is coming out of people's bodies, out of an experience that they're having of being targeted in this world that has robbed them of humanity and dignity. To come to that table where somebody is crying out saying, stop, I need breath, I need life, and say, will you give me a long discourse and thesis on how you feel about X, Y, and Z? How human are we being? Who would walk up to somebody who's being beaten in the middle of a street and say, tell me how you feel about Israel? The first thing you need to do is get rid of the condition of them being beaten so that they can be human with you. And when we're both human and when we're both in our bodies and we're both free, then we can have discussions about how we want to be free and to what extent and what it should look like. But I think right now, as a human, as a global citizen, I want the depth and breadth of us to be free. There's too much oppression in the world right now. And what I saw in the Black Lives Matter movement, in the Women's March movement, were millions of people coming out in their bodies in the street to say, it matters to my humanity that we all get free. And when that's a human moment, I want us as Jews to arrive at that moment with our humanity first on our lips and to have an I story about why our humanity is first on our lips. If you're so busy being there because it means something to you, that's why you're there. I'm not worried about why he, she, and they are there. I'm here because this is something that I need in my body. So what do we need in our body, in our collective body as a Jewish people that brings us to the cause of justice? If we haven't answered that question, I don't think it's the time to ask for discourse and political theories. I think it's the time to find that story. So in our bodies, what's your I story? I ask people, why are you here? Are you here to save those poor, unfortunate souls? And you want, in order to feel good about saving those poor, unfortunate souls, them to come back at you with a story that validates that decision and choice? Or are you here because you are the poor, unfortunate soul? Because your people have suffered over thousands of years? Because you have not forgotten Leo Frank? Because you understand that our access in this country has been conditional to us as Jews? Because you know that your mama and your grandmother had to get a nose job and straighten their hair and make it blonde in order to survive in the Ivy League schools? Because you know that your granddaddy couldn't get a job as a lawyer because they weren't accepting lawyers in the institutions of this country that were given legal degrees? Because you know that maybe your uncle came through the medical institutions of this country and then had to found a Jewish hospital in order to work as a doctor? What are our stories? Literally, not just you, but your family. What are our stories that bring us proximate to the need for justice? That were there no one else out there but us, we would be out there blowing the shofar and crying out, this too is for us. That causes you to stop being distracted by what somebody else is doing. It causes us also to do the work of saying that Jews are not white. If I were to snap my fingers like this and bring all the Jews that exist in this world into this Zoom room with us right now, they would be more diverse than the United Nations itself. With that being true, this is the work of us to recover us, to recover all of us, so that when we finally meet each other on that day, that becomes true. Bayomahu yiyeh Hashem echad u'shmo echad. On that day, Hashem's name and the manifestation of how we experience God and justice will be the same. That is a day without racism. That is a day that we are waiting for as a Jewish people. I don't need no Black Lives Matter leaders or no Women's March leaders to tell me that that's why I'm standing there in front of a million people. I'm standing there because justice and liberation is for me. It's a part of a tradition that I've been taught from the time I was a child. And so I want us out there with an I voice that doesn't get us so distracted by, I have to hear somebody else's politics before I'm able to get out in the street. Justice is for Jews. Justice is for us. And we have to find our stories to be able to be out there for that. So I'm not diverting myself away from the question. I know there's a lot to talk about, but I talk about those things in relationship. I talk about those things once I'm proximate to another person's humanity and they're proximate to mine, because then I know when we disagree, we can hold it. If I come first without being in relationships, they're not holding me and I'm not holding them. And the fact that we're disagreeing actually is pushing us farther apart when what we actually need is justice. So that's how I approach that question. And I hope that's satisfactory.